So good morning. This is Arvind. In today's session, we will be discussing about file handling in C. After going through this chapter, we should be able to understand about the files, operations on files, file I/O functions, random accessing of files, error handling during file I/O operations, and command line arguments. Now let us see what is a file. A file is nothing but it is an external collection of related data treated as a unit. A file is a place on a disk where a group of related data is stored and retrieved whenever necessary without destroying the data. So the primary purpose of this file is to keep the record of data. A record is nothing but it is a group of related fields, and a field is a group of characters which convey the meaning. So files are stored in auxiliary or secondary storage devices. Why these files are stored in auxiliary or secondary storage devices means a computer stores programs and data in secondary memory in the files in the form of files. Storing programs and data permanently in primary memory is not preferred due to some reasons, because the primary memory is usually too small to permanently store the data or programs. And the one more cause for the reason is the primary memory is volatile storage device. That means which loses its contents when the power goes off. For these reasons, we are going to store the data in either auxiliary memory or secondary storage devices. These secondary storage devices are generally your hard disk, CD drives and DVD drives and magnetic tapes. Each file, whatever the files we are storing in this secondary storage, should end somewhere. So it will be having some end of a file, and or that is the end of a structure. Yeah, whenever we want to store the file or whenever we want to perform any operation on these files, the files must first be opened properly so that it can be accessed for reading or writing. When after completion of the file with the file, we need to close the file. So these are the things what we need to do with the file. Next, let us see what are the advantages of using files. So here each program revolves around some data. It requires some inputs, performs manipulations over them, produce required outputs. So far in our all earlier programs, the inputs are originated from some standard input device like keyboard with the help of scanf, getchar and getS functions. We display the output produced through the standard output device screen by use of I/O functions like printf, putchar and putS. So these type of I/O operations are having some drawbacks. Those drawbacks are the data involved in these I/O operations are lost when the program is exited or when the power goes off. And the second disadvantage is this type of storing the data or using the getting the data from the keyboard and storing it in the monitor is not ideal for all kinds of programs. That's the reason we need to go for the concept of files. Now there are two types of files. One is text files and the other one is binary files. So the text files are those files that contains letters, digits and symbols. A text file mainly contains character coded from the ASCII character set. In C, by default, a file stream operations are performed in the text mode, but supports binary file operations also. Whereas a binary file is a sequential access file in which data are stored and read back one after another in the binary format instead of ASCII format. A binary file is a file that uses 8 bits of bytes for storing the information. In contrast, to the binary file, the text file uses only 7 bits, allowing the 8th bit to be 0. So binary format data files normally take less space. So text mode is inefficient for storing large amounts of numerical data because it occupies a large space. Only solution to this is to open a file in the binary mode, because which takes lesser space than that of the text mode. Now let us see what are the different operations what we can perform on the file server. So in order to perform the basic file operations, C supports a number of functions. Some of the important file handling functions available in C library are fopen. So what this fopen function is going to do is, it is going to create a new file for use if it is existing. It opens an existing file for the use, whereas fclose closes the file which has been opened for user. Fclose all, this function closes all the files which are opened. And we have some functions for reading and writing the data, like fgetc reads the character from the file, fputc writes the character to a file, fprintf writes a set of data values to the file, fscanf reads the set of data values from files, getw reads an integer from the file, putw writes an integer to the file, getus reads a string from a file, putus writes a string to a file. And besides that, we have fread, fwrite, which are used to read and write the binary files. Then fseek function, which sets the position to the desired point in a file. Ftel gives the current position in the file, and rewrite sets the position at the beginning of the file. Now let us see what are the basic operations what we can perform on a file. So here basically what we can do, for any file we need to give a name, then we need to open the file to do some operations. The operations what we can perform are, we can read the data from the file, or we can write the data from the file. Once after completion of our operations, we are going to close the file. So to do these operations, the stored data in a file, three things have to be specified for the operating system. So if we are going to specify these three things, then we can do these kind of operations on the files. The first operation what we need to specify to the operating system is file name. It is a string of characters that make up a valid file name, which may contain two parts. One is a primary name and an optional period with the extension, that is for example program1.c, myfirst.java, data.txt, like this. So these extensions can be given depending on the usage of the file. Like if the file is used for storing text, we use .txt extension. If the file is to store C programs, we give .c extension. If the file is an header file, we give .h extension, like that. So depending on what type of file we are using, we are going to use that kind of extension. For example, if it is a Java file, .java. If it is a C++ file, .cpp extension, like that. So here what we are going to do is, we are going to store the data into the file and we are going to give the file. Now what we need to do, we need to create a data structure. So it is defined as file in the library of a standard IO function definition, that is stdio.h itself. We are in that particular standard library function library itself, we have one definition called as file. Therefore all files are declared as a type of file. This file is a defined data type, and this file, how we are going to use it, we are going to use it as an pointer type. So file is a pointer type, and the purpose of this creating or giving a name to the file and creating a data structure to the file is, we need to open it and we need to perform some operations for reading, writing, appending, like that. So here the main syntax is, file pointer is equal to fopen file name comma mode. We have different types of modes. Basically there are six types of modes what we are going to use in files. One is read mode. So read mode, for read mode we are going to use symbol R. So what the read mode does means the read mode opens an existing file for reading. When the file is opened in this mode, the file marker or the pointer is positioned to the beginning of the file. So the file pointer will be placed to the first character. The file must already exist. If it does not exist, a null is returned as an error. If we try to write a file opened in a read mode, an error occurs. So if the file is in opened in a read mode and we are trying to write it on the file, then an error occurs. The syntax is file pointer is equal to fopen file name comma r, where r is for read mode. Then the next mode is write mode. So for write mode, we are going to use the symbol w. The write mode opens a file for writing. If the file does not exist, it is created. Whereas in the read mode, if the file does not exist, what it is going to do? It is going to give an error message null. Whereas if you are opening the file in the write mode, if the file does not exist, it will create a new file with the name we are specifying. If it already exists, it is open and all its data is erased. So one thing, whenever it opens a file in a write mode, what it will do? The file it will open, but it will erase the complete data. The file pointer is positioned at the beginning of the file. It gives an error if we try to read from a file opened in the write mode. So if we are opening the file to write, we can write only, we cannot read. Now let us see another kind of mode, that is append mode. Append mode, we are going to use the symbol A. So the append mode opens an existing file for writing instead of creating a new file. However, the writing starts after the last character in the existing file. That is, if you are opening a file in a write mode, what it is going to do? It is going to erase the data. Whereas if you are going to open it in an append mode, what it is going to do? It will come to the end of the file. So it is not going to erase the data. From the end of the file, it is will be in a position to write the data. So this is a new data, that is a new data can be added or appended at the end of the file. If the file does not exist, a new file is created and opened. So like write mode, here we can, if that file what we are trying to open in an append mode, if it does not exist, what it will do? It will create a new file. In this case, the writing will start at the beginning of the file. So f file pointer is equal to, the syntax is file pointer is equal to f open file name comma a. So here there is another mode, that is a read and write mode. For both reading and writing, we are going to use R plus. So in this mode, file is opened for both reading and writing of the data. If the file does not exist, then null is returned. So here what we can do, we can read the data as well as we can write the data. Whereas if you are opening it is an in a read mode, you can only read. If you are opening in a write mode, you can only write. Whereas if you are using R plus, you can both read and write. Whereas W plus, read and write mode, this is also a read and write mode, but in this mode, the file is opened for both writing and reading the data. If the file already exists, its contents are erased. Like write mode, the content will get erased. And if a file does not exist, then a new file is created. The syntax for all these three are one and the same. The only thing is, at the mode position, it is going to place either R, W, A, R plus, W plus, A plus. Next, there is an append A plus mode, append and read. So in this mode, the file is open for reading the data as well as the data can be added at the end of the file. So these are the different types of modes what we can use whenever we are trying to open a file. So note, to perform operations on binary files, the following modes are applicable with the extension B. Like if we are, see, all these modes what we are using are for text files. Suppose if they are write binary files, R B, W B, A B, R plus B, W plus B, A plus B. So these are the different modes what we are going to use for performing the different operations on the files. Now let us see another thing, that is naming and opening a file. So what is the procedure for naming and opening a file? A name is given to the file used to store the data. A file name is a string of characters that make up a valid file name for operating system. It contains two parts. The primary is a name and an optional period with an extension, that is student.txt, file.txt, marks.doc, plain.c, first program.java. Like this we are going to use different extensions. So already we have discussed that these extensions can be given depending upon the usage of the file. Like if we are using, the file is used for storing text, we use a .txt extension. If it is a Java file, we are going to use a .c extension. If it is a C programming file, we are going to use a .cpp extension. Like that, based on the file type, depending on the usage of the file type, we are going to give the extension. Then once after extension, what we need to do? We are going to declaring the file. So to declare the file or to open a file, what we need to do is we need to create a declaration. The syntax for it is file pointer FP. So FP is nothing but it is a file pointer. That is the name of the file pointer. So this is the pointer where you are based on the mode what you are using, the cursor is going to be placed at that particular position. Then after that, file pointer FP. FP is equal to F open of file name comma mode. So this is the two words that are mandatory for opening any file. Here file is a data structure defined for the files. FP is a file pointer to the data type file. File name is the name of the file. Mode tells the purpose of opening the file. Now let us see some of the commands for reading a file. So for reading, that is for taking the input, what we are going to into the file for reading the data into the file, we are going to use some commands like getc, fscanf, getw, fgets, fread. So here in depth we will be studying about each and every function. So for example, if getc is used to read the character from a file that has been opened for read operation, the syntax is c is equal to getc of file point. So whatever the file pointer is placing, it is going to read the first character and it will be placing in the c. C is of type integer. Okay, this statement reads a character from the file pointed to the file pointer and assigns it to the c. It returns an end of file marker EOF when the end of the file has been reached. So here what we are going to use, by using the loops concept, we are going to read character by character. Then we have another for reading the file is fscanf. So this is, which are something similar to your scanf function. So this function is similar to that of scanf function, except that it works on files. There we are going to use a normal scanning of the file from the keyboard. Here we are going to write the file, read the file, or scanf, read the file from the hard disk, secondary storage device. So the syntax is fscanf, file pointer, control string, and list. Here the above statement reads string type data and integer type data from the file. So here we can read both. So if you see the example, fscanf f1 percentage s percentage d str ampersand num. So here we have not represented ampersand str, because here string we should not put the ampersand. String itself talks about the address. So here directly, whereas coming to integer, we have put the ampersand num. Similarly, getw, this function is used to read the integers from the file. Getw of file pointer is the syntax for reading the word. Fgetc, fgets, this function reads the string from a file pointer
by a file pointer, it also copies. So instead of reading character by character, it is going to read string by string. So to a memory location referred by an array. The syntax for reading fget_s is fget_s of string comma number of bytes. So how many number of bytes of data need to be stored into the file by using the file pointer. Next, the command is fread. So this fread, this function is generally used for reading a structured block, that is for binary files. The fread command here, the function is used for reading the entire structured block from a given file. So fread ampersand struct name, size of structure name, comma one comma file pointer. So in depth, that is the syntax of fread command. We will discuss about fread, fgets, getw, fscanf, fgetc, all these things in the next topics. Okay. Now, let us see. Similarly, we can use write commands to writing a data into a file. To write into a file, the following C functions we are going to use. Fputc, this function writes a character to a file that has been opened in a write mode. Next, fprintf, this function performs function similar to the printf, but this we are going to use on files. So when we are trying to print the data, that is read the data from the hard disk and writing it onto the monitor, we are going to use fprintf. Putw, putw writes an integer to a file. Fputc, this function writes a string into a file pointer by the file pointer specified. Fwrite, this function is used to write the entire block structure to the given file. So these are the different commands. Now let us see the last operation. So once after completing all the operations, what we need to do? We need to close the file. So a file is closed as soon as all operations on it have been completed. Closing a file ensures that the outstanding information associated with the file is flushed out from the buffer and all links to the file are broken. Another instance where we have to close a file is to reopen the same file in a different mode. So library functions for closing a file is fclose of file pointer. So whatever the file we have opened using the file pointer, that file pointer we need to mention it in the syntax of fclose. For example, fclose of fp, where fp is a file pointer returned by a call of fopen. Fclose returns 0 on a success, fclose returns minus 1 if it is an error. Once a file is closed, its file pointer can be reused for another file, another purpose. So fclose all is another function which can be used for closing all the opened files at one glance. So at a time we can close all the files. Now let us see the character oriented functions. The character oriented functions are fgetc and fputc function. So fgetc is used to read the character from a file. The syntax for fgetc is ch is equal to fgetc of fptr, where fptr is a file pointer. So ch is a variable of character type and fptr is a pointer to the file type. The function reads the character from the file denoted by fptr and returns the character value, which is collected by the variable ch. Similarly, we have another function, that is fputc. Fputc is to write the character onto the file. The syntax is fputc of ch comma fp. So here, where ch represents the character and fp, a pointer to the file, represents a file. The function writes the content of ch onto the file represented by the file pointer. So these are the two commands what we are going to use for reading the data. Reading the data from the file, reading character by character from the file and writing character by character onto the file. Now let us see an example program for character oriented functions. So here the first character function what we are going to use is to create a file consisting of characters using fputc. So here if you can see, fptr is declared to be a pointer variable of file type, and ch is declared to be a variable of character type. The file pointer variable is represents the file to be created by the program, and the variable ch of character type is to collect the characters one at a time entered through the standard input device keyboard. Note that the external file text.data is opened in W mode. So we are going to open it in a write mode. So till we type an end of file character, that is control Z. So until we press the control Z, all the characters are written into the external file text.data denoted by the file pointer in the program. Once the character end of file is typed, that is control Z is typed, that loop terminates. So here note that the file is then closed by invoking fclose function. So this is how we are going to use the file. Now let us see how we can read a file consisting of characters using fgetc. So here again, ftr is declared to be a pointer variable of type file type, and ch is declared to be a variable of character type. The file opens pointer variable is represent the file txt dot data to be read by the program, and the variable ch of char type is to collect the character one at a time read from the file. Note that the external file text.data is now opened in read mode. So previously we have opened in write mode. Now so what we are doing, we are getting the data from the hard disk, from the external device. So we are reading the data which is already available. So here the function feof, if you can see here feof, so here feof is nothing but it checks for the end of the file being read. So it takes the file pointer to the file as the argument and returns one if the end is reached, otherwise it returns zero. So in the above looping segment, till the end of the file text.data is reached, all the characters are read and displayed. So this after completion of the things, so what we are going to do, we are going to close the file. So here instead of ch is equal to fgetc file pointer not equal to end of file, we can also write feof until the end of the file. So these are the two ways what we can use for reading until the end of the file. Now let us see the next one here, that is string oriented functions. So here the string oriented functions are fputs and fgets. So fputs is to write a string onto a file, and the syntax is fputs of buffer comma size comma file point fputs buffer comma file pointer. So buffer is the name of the character array, and fptr is the pointer to the file type. So the function writes the string represented by the buffer to the file pointed by the file pointer. Now the next one is fgets. So here fgets, the syntax for fgets is fgets buffer comma size comma file pointer. So here buffer is the name of character array, size is an integer value, file pointer is a pointer to the file type. The function reads a string of maximum size minus one characters from the file pointed to the file pointed by the file pointer, and copies it into the memory area denoted by the buffer. So these are the two functions by which we are going to read and write the strings into the file. So here previous example fputc and fgetc character by character, here string by string we are going to copy the data. Now let us see the first example for creating a file consisting of string using fputc. So here we are going to use fputc. Here fptr, similar fashion, fptr is declared to be a variable of type pointer to file type. Str is declared to be an array of character type, and the size is considered to be 10. Variable I and n are declared to be of int type. The file variable fptr is denoted the file student.data. So student.data to be created by the program. So the string variable str is to collect the string entered through the keyboard, which is then written to the file. The variable n is to accept the number of strings to be accepted, and I acts as a control variable in the for loop used. So the statement file pointer is equal to f open of student.data comma w opens the file student.data in write mode and assigns a reference to the file to file pointer. After accepting the number of students into the variable n, n strings are accepted and returned to the file. And once after completing the operations, what we are doing? We are going to close the file. So f close of fptr is the statement what we are going to use, or the function what we are going to use for closing the files once after performing the operation. Now let us see the program to read a file consisting of string using fgets. So here also the variable fptr is declared to be a pointer of file type. Str is declared to be an array of character type of size 10. The file variable fptr is denoted, and the file student.data to be read by the program. The string variable str is to collect the string read from the file. Here the statement fptr is equal to fopen student.data comma r opens the file student.data in a read mode. So student.data should exist, otherwise fopen returns null. So if you are trying to read a file which is which does not exist, I am trying to read a book which is the book is itself is not available, what will happen? So to read any book, first with the book should exist. So whenever we are opening in a read mode, if the file is not existing, what it will do? It will return a null value. So here the while loop setups read each string in the file student.data and displays it onto the screen. Okay, as long as the end of the file is not reached, the program continues to read strings and displays them onto the screen. So this standard to the standard output device. On the exit of the loop, the file student.data is closed. So by using the file pointer, we are going to close the student.data. So this is how we are going to use the string handling functions. And now let us see the mixed data oriented functions, that is integers, characters, like that. If there are mixed type oriented files, we are going to use fprintf and fscanf. Fprintf is to write multiple data items which may are not be of a different type of files. So the syntax for fprintf is fprintf of file pointer, control string, and the argument list. So this is that is the syntax. It can be observed that the syntax of fprintf is similar to that of the printf, except the presence of an external parameter fptr. What is fptr? A pointer to the file type. So the parameter fptr associates with the file that has been opened for writing. So control string specifies the format specifier, and the argument list command separates variables. So the values of which are to be returned to the file. So here next command is fscanf. So here fscanf is to read multiple data items which may be of different types from the file. The syntax is that is at a time we can read strings, characters, floating point values, character arrays, all these things. So multiple things can happen. So here the syntax for fscanf is fscanf, fptr, control string and argument list. It can be observed that the syntax of scanf is similar to that of the scanf, except the presence of external parameter fptr. So this fptr is the only thing which is being added additional to that of the scanf function. Okay, so here the parameter fptr is associated with the file that has been opened for reading. So the control string specifies the format specifiers. Argument list contains comma separated variables preceded by the address of operator ampersand. So except for strings, we need to use a ampersand symbol and symbol into which the data is read from the file are to be copied. So this is how we are going to use fprintf and fscanf commands. Now let us see an example program to create a file consisting of student details using fprintf. So here the student structure, student is defined with the fields roll number, name and percentage. In the main variable, fptr is declared to be a pointer to file type, and it is to denote the file student. So the data to be created by the program is x. So x we are going to use to create the program. X is declared to be a variable of struct student type, which is to collect the student details accepted through the keyboard. So the statement fptr is equal to fopen student dot data w opens the file student.data in a write mode and assigns a reference to the file variable fptr. So the for loop segment enables us to accept n student details and write them onto the file student.data. So this is the command what we are going to use. So if you can see here, fprintf except this file pointer, remaining all the things are the one and the same. Okay, now let us see another program for reading a file consisting of student details by using fscanf. So here the structure, here also we have created a structure. Student is defined with the fields roll number, name and percentage. In the main function, variable fptr is declared to be a pointer to file type, and it is to denote the file student.data to read by the program. X is declared to be a variable of struct student type, which is to collect the student details read from the file student.data. So the statement fptr is equal to fopen student.data comma r, what it does, it opens a file in a read mode and assigns references to the file by using the file pointer fptr. So, and the while loop segment enables us to read all the student details and displays them on the screen. On the exit of the loop, as common, we need to close the file using the file pointer. So these are the mixed data oriented functions. Next, reading and writing structures. So there are, as we said, that there are many disadvantages by using text files, because the text files occupy more memory than compared to that of the binary files. So the main disadvantage of fprintf is all data types are treated as characters. For example, consider the data 1, 2, 3, 4 occupies 2 bytes in memory, but when it is transformed to the disk file using fprintf, the function would occupy 4 bytes of memory. For each character, 1 byte would be required. Even for float also, each digit includes a dot requires 1 byte. Thus, a large amount of integers or float data requires a large space on the disk. Hence, in text mode, storing of numeric data on the disk turns out to be inefficient. To overcome this problem, the file should read and write in binary mode using the function fread and fwrite. fwrite function is used to write a structured block to a given file. So its syntax is fwrite ampersand struct variable size of struct integer file pointer. Okay, so here the first argument is the address of the structure to be written to the disk. The second argument is the size of the structure in bytes. The third argument is the number of such structures, that is nothing but its number of records that the user wants to write at one time. And the last argument is the file pointer. Then fread function is used for reading the entire structure block from a given file. The syntax is same as fwrite function, that is fread ampersand structure variable size of struct integer file pointer. The same thing, the first argument is the address of the structure to be read to the disk, read from the file. The second argument is the size of the structure in bytes, and the third argument is the number of such structures or records that the user want to read at one time, and the last argument is the file pointer. So this is the syntax of reading and writing structures in a binary format. For this also I have shown you two programs, one for writing structures and the other for reading structures. Everything is one and the same, the only the syntax. See, if you see that here all these programs, only the code change will be just 3 to 4 lines of code, there will be change. Remaining everything will be one and the same. That's why this files concept is very easy to understand and very easy to learn. Okay. Now, let us see what is a random access files and what is the necessity of random access files. So, at time we need to access only a particular part of a file rather than accessing all the data sequentially. So which can be achieved with the help of functions fseek, ftl, rewind available in IO library. So here, instead of reading the data from starting to the ending, when we want the last record to be read, suppose if the file is having 100 records and I want the 100th record, what I need to do to read the 100th record, if I am going in a sequential order, I need to read 99 records, then we need to go for the 100th record. So this generally will happen in magnetic tapes. Previously, when you used to hear audio songs in tape recorder by using magnetic tape type files, to rewind or fast forward, we need to come to the end. We need, without watching the starting, we cannot go end and to come to the forward position. But now, once when the CDs and DVD players have come, we can skip to any part, any song as we like. If you press the function, it will go directly to that particular point. In that similar fashion, whenever we try to read the data using a, we can randomly access. So the files also can be read randomly. So all the programs which have been written so far reading the content of files employed sequential access mode. That is, the contents were read from the beginning of the file till their end is reached in a serial manner. Many of the times we need to access the content at a particular positions in the file, not necessary from the beginning till the end. This is referred as a random access of files. So here we have certain functions like ftl, rewind, fseek. So these are some functions what we are going to see for random access files. Here ftl. So ftl function, this function tells or returns the value of the current position in the file. The value is counted from the beginning of the file. So the syntax is used is position is equal to ftl of f pointer. So the syntax is position is equal to ftl of fptr, where fptr is the pointer which points to the file. Here I have given the example n. So what is n? N is the position. So n would give the relative offset of the current position. This means that already n bytes have been read or written from the file. Okay, and next one is rewind. So here we have another function like rewind. So what this rewind does, it takes the file pointer and resets the position to the starting of the file. When we rewind, what will happen? It will take us to the starting pointer. So rewind of file pointer, what it will do? It will rewind to the starting position. So n is when we, after rewinding, if we say n is equal to f tilde of file pointer, it will show you the value 0, because already it has been rewinded and the file pointer has come to the starting position. So the next is fseek. So this function fseek is used for setting the pointer position in the file at the specified position. So the syntax of its usage is fseek of file pointer, comma, displacement, comma, pointer position. That is file pointer, offset value, and the position. Where file pointer is a pointer which points to the file. Displacement or offset is a positive or negative. This is the number of bytes which are skipped backward or forward. So if it is backward, we are going to use a negative. If it is forward, we are going to use positive from the current position. The third parameter, pointer position, can take one of the following three values, that is either 0, 1 or 2. The meaning of these values are given in the table which I have shown here. So 0, seek underscore set, beginning of the file. If it is 0, it is the beginning of the file. If it is 1, it is the current position. If it is 2, it is the end of the file. Here I have given some example, fseek fpr, a file pointer of 10, 0. So the meaning of 0 is it is at the beginning of the file. Since the value 10 is positive, so it will be moving in the forward direction. So the file pointer was from the beginning, it will move 10 characters forward direction. Next, fseek of file pointer 10, seek set. So when I say seek set, from the beginning, I can write either in this format or I can write in this format. So the file pointer is repositioned in the forward direction 10 bytes. If I say minus 10, from the ending 10 positions, it will come in the backward direction. So when the portion is successful, fseek returns 0, and when we attempt to move a file beyond boundaries, fseek returns minus 1. Suppose if I am at the end of the file, and I am at the end of the file and I want to trying to fast forward. So once after the end of the file, I cannot go forward. So at that time, it will give an error message. Similarly, I am at the beginning and I want to rewind. When I am at the beginning, I cannot go rewind. So at that point of time also, it gives an error message. So these are the things what we are going to use. See here I have given some operations for fseek function. So fseek file pointer 0L0. So the L means go left. So go to the beginning, similar to, it is something which is similar to rewind. So I am moving leftwards. Say fseek fp 0l comma 1, stay at the current position. Fseek fp 0l comma 2 to get the end of the file, pass the last character of the file. Fseek f file pointer m comma 0, moves the m plus 1th byte in the file. So seek fp m comma 1, go forward by m bytes. Fseek fp minus m comma 1, go backward. Since it is a negative value, it goes backward by m bytes from the current position. Fseek minus m comma 2, so go backward by m bytes from the end of the file. So here 1 means at the current position, 2 says that end of the position, 0 says that at the starting position. Here positive says that forward direction, negative says that in the negative direction. M says number of bytes. And file fp is the nothing but it is the file pointer. Now let us see some of the error handlings in files. So whenever we are going to perform illegal operations on files, we will get some error messages. It is possible that an error may occur during the IO operations on the file. So the typical error situations include trying to read beyond the end of the file mark, device overflow, trying to use the file that has not been opened, trying to perform an operation on the file when the file is opened for another type of operation, opening a file with an invalid file name, attempt to write a write protected file. So these are the different things, mistakes what we can do. Based on these mistakes, we are going to get the errors. So the file IO operations cannot always be expected to be smooth sailing. During the course of IO operation, some errors may be encountered. As a consequence of an error condition, the underlying program may permanently terminate or it may produce onerous results. So let us now try to enumerate the situation which leads to error conditions and then understand how they can be encountered. So first one is FEOF. So FEOF, the FEOF function can be used to test for an end of the file condition. It takes the file pointer as its only argument and returns a non-zero integer value if all the data from the specified file has been read, and returns a zero otherwise. If file pointer is a pointer to the file that has just opened for reading, then the statement if FEOF of FP, if I use that command, it will print the end of the data, would display the message end of data on reaching the end of the file condition. So in the similar fashion, F error. This F error function reports the status of the file indicated. It also takes a file pointer as its argument and returns a non-zero integer if an error has been detected up to the point. During processing, it returns zero otherwise. So this statement, how we can use this is, if F error of FP not equal to zero, so it prints an error has occurred. If some error has occurred, we can use that particular function. FP is equal to null. So when we will get null? When we are trying to open a in a read mode and the file does not exist. So we know that whenever a file is opened for using the fopen function and the file pointer is returned, if the file cannot be opened for some reason, then the function will return an null pointer. So like this, we can handle different kinds of errors. And the last one is F error. It is a standard library function which prints the error message specified by the compiler. For example, if F error of FP, P error of a file name. So this ends the file concept. Thank you. Thank you very much for having a great session.